Hi, I'm Gaylerd. Hey, welcome back to the Big DAWG Acoustic Guitar Series. In this lesson, I'm going to show you how to make transitions in the A minor. Now, in the previous lesson, you learned how to put those riffs and fills for the E minor chord where you change several different chords. Well, that was just using those notes, the E minor tab chord notes, to make changes, okay? Nice, smooth little transitions. But now I want to take it a step further. I want to show you how to use those tab chord notes for a chord and use them as bass fills to make a transition. When you start using those as bass fills, man, you make that song come to life and it really makes it sound cool. Now let me show you what I'm talking about. There was a song back in the 60s called The House of the Rising Sun. Very popular song. And if you were to play it on an acoustic guitar, it would sound like average acoustic guitar playing would sound like this. Okay, that's average guitar. We don't want to play average acoustic guitar. We want to play Big DAWG acoustic guitar. That means adding those bass riffs in there for the transitions and just making that song come to life. And it would sound something like this. They call the rising sun. It's been the ruin of many a poor girl. Thank God I know I am. Big difference in the way that song plays out and the way it sounds when you have those bass fills in there. It just brings out the intent of that song. And I don't know if those are the right bass riffs or not. It doesn't matter. The audience will hear you play those and they'll just play along with it. They'll think that's the right one because it just sounds right. The intent of the song comes through. And you do it by using those chord tab notes for each chord that you play. So every time you learn a chord, those tab notes that you learn can be used as bass fills or lead riffs or just transitions. And you can use them in any pattern, right? You just on a lead riff, you can use it in any pattern. On the bass fill, you want it to make the transition sound right, or the bass, like a bass player would be playing it. That's how you have to think. When you use those bass fills, if you were a bass player, what would you be putting into it? Don't worry about what they're doing on a song. You can hear it in a song and you may even play the same notes that they do, but you don't have to. You have to play the intent of the song. So now what I want to do is take you to the A minor, show you how to make some transitions with some bass fills and some lead riffs, and we're going to change into several different chords. Now remember, you don't have to use the same transitions I'm doing. I'm going to show you how to use it, then it's going to be up to you, because we're going to learn House of the Rising Sun. That's going to be a song challenge where you're going to put your own lead riffs and the bass fills into it and make that song come to life for you. You're going to hear it in your heart and then you'll play it. All right, so for right now, get your pick, get your guitar, meet me back in the studio, and we'll learn some transitions from the A minor. Okay, so let me show you a few transitions that you can use using those notes. There's a few chords that are really go well with the A minor, and it's E, you've got a C, a D, an F goes well with it, and so does a G. So let's try and let me show you a few transitions that you can use, and you can use these notes whether you're using them as bass fills or lead riffs, or just transition notes, run notes to get to it. But let's say you wanted to go to an E. Now, as I shared with you earlier in the E minor, whenever you make a transition to a chord, what's really important is that you can use any of those notes that are in the chord tab. Use any note in any pattern when you're doing a transition to get to another chord. As long as when you get ready to hit that next chord, and I'm going to use an E for this example. When you hit that chord, you've got to hit the bass note of that chord. And as soon as you hit that, what you're doing is actually transitioning now into the tab notes for that chord. So the E, you would, once you hit the E, you would use those notes that you learned on the E minor. You'd use those notes if you went to an E minor. You'll learn the E chord later and you'll be able to, you'll know what those chords are, pretty similar to the E minor. But the point is that when you change to a chord, as soon as you hit that chord, you're then transitioning to put into effect the chord or the tab notes for that chord. So let's do it for an E minor. So as soon as we can use any of those tab notes, as long as when we hit the E minor, we're going to hit that open six or a full E chord. Either one's going to work, because when you hit that full chord, you're actually hitting that bass note in there, and the audience will hear the intent of that song. So let me show you a couple of runs that you could use going to an E. Now remember, you can use anything you want to. I'm just showing you a few to get you started so you can practice running your transitions on all of these different chords. Here's an A minor. We want to go to an E. If we had a long transition, you could do something like this. Oops, I messed that up. Now, you don't have to use all those notes. Maybe you just, if you had a short transition, you just use a couple of them. As soon as I get down there, I'm hitting that open E. Okay. Now you can practice. Any of those notes, as long as you get down there and hit that E. Let's say that you were going to a C. That's actually, I use that particular riff when I do, I think it's, Have You Ever Seen the Rain? Okay. So you can use that riff. You could use a, you could do a walk-up, and there's, that would be a good bass riff to use. Just like that. Use those three notes get to a C as a bass riff. Now there's another one that you can use, is just an open E and an open A. Okay. Now let's say you wanted to go to a D minor. Okay, lots of ways to go to the D minor. If you wanted to start up high, any of those note patterns. I'm just trying to give you examples because I want you to take this now and use your own transitions to try each one of those chords. Let's try to go to a G. Okay, lots of ways to go to a G. What about an F chord? If you wanted to go to an F, you'd need to end up on the F note right here. But here's what I do when, and I think I showed you this on the E minor. If not, I'm going to show you now. When you go to an F chord, two things you can do. If you're playing the F bar chord, then you want to make sure you're picking up your F note here. If you're playing a regular F, then you want to make sure you're picking up your D, E, F. That's the third note on the fourth string, that F note. But when I play an F chord, I usually play F with that C bass in there. Okay, so when you do that, just make sure that you're hitting both those notes so that you're hitting that F note. hit that full chord. So if you're going to an A minor, you could use these notes. Like that. Okay. All kinds of different changes that you can use. What I want you to do is just make your own transitions using those notes to the E chord, A minor to C, A minor to D, A minor to D minor. Be the same chord, just I want you to get your fingers changing there. A minor to F, and A minor to G. Get comfortable using some bass riffs, maybe, if you're on a C. Little bass riffs to get up to it, like we did on House of the Rising Sun. All I'm doing there is I'm doing that little walk-up, and that's what that bass would be doing. There is a house. Okay, like that. So just try doing your different bass riffs, different lead riffs, different transition riffs to each one of those chords. And make sure that you're comfortable with those changes and that you're able to change it and make your chords sound clean when you do that transition. You want your transitions to be nice and smooth. And I'll see you in the next lesson.